Cuba traigo el son ritmo sabroso.
Hi everyone! Welcome to For Solidarity for Cuba, an international concert against the U.S. blockade on Cuba, organized by the International U.S.-Cuba Normalization Conference Committee and co-sponsored by Hot House Global. My name is Allison Bodine. I'm an organizer with the International U.S.-Cuba Normalization Conference Committee from the Fire This Time Movement for Social Justice in Canada. I am honored to be emceeing our program here tonight. Before we begin the concert, I want to introduce Raul Cuza, one of the co-producers of tonight's amazing lineup, who is bringing us greetings direct from Havana, Cuba. Over to you, Raul.
Thank you, Allison. Hi, my name is Raul Cuza, and I'm one of the co-producers of the show that you're going to see tonight. I welcome you. I'm in Havana, Cuba right now, and I'm delighted to present to you several artists and intellectuals who are convinced that blockage on Cuba should end now. So, once again, I welcome you to this wonderful event for life, for peace, for culture, humanism, and in solidarity with our people, with the people of Cuba and the people of the United States of America. Enjoy.
Thank you, Raul. And we thank all of you for joining us here today as we enjoy 2 hours of inspiring world-renowned musicians and poets from the U.S., Canada, Quebec, and Cuba, all gathered here to tell Washington, D.C., now is the time to end the cruel and inhuman U.S. blockade on Cuba. This cultural event is kicking off the Weekend of Solidarity to end the U.S. blockade on Cuba, taking place on Saturday and Sunday, November 14th and 15th, 2020. The International U.S.-Cuba Normalization Conference Committee invites you to join us tomorrow and Sunday for 3 dynamic online workshops on preparing to make 2021 the year to end the over 60 years of unjust blockade. The weekend will feature Jose Ramon Cabañas, Cuba's ambassador to the United States, Josefina Vidal, Cuba's ambassador to Canada, Pedro Luis Pedroso Cuesta, the permanent ambassador of Cuba to the United Nations, and Fernando González Yort, president of the Cuban Institute of Friendship with the Peoples, ECAP, and Cuban Five Hero, as well as other dynamic speakers from across the United States, Canada, Quebec, and Puerto Rico, including doctors Samira Adri and Andy Coates, who will discuss Cuba's leading role in fighting the COVID-19 pandemic around the world. For more information and to register for the weekend of events, click the link in the chat or visit www.us-cubanormalization.org. Now back to the show. In the first half of this beautiful program, we have Miguel Barnett, Camerata de la Habana, Normand Raymond, Jane Bunet y Mekeke, Muñequitos de Matanzas, Jack Hirschman, and Nancy Morejon. Enjoy.
Desde aquí, desde la sede de la Unión de Escritores y Artistas de Cuba, y a nombre de los escritores y artistas cubanos, quiero enviarle un saludo muy afectuoso a los miembros del Comité de Solidaridad con Cuba en los Estados Unidos. La historia de Cuba no se puede hacer, no se puede contar sin los vínculos profundos y sistemáticos con la historia de los Estados Unidos. Como soy un hombre optimista, estoy convencido que esa historia cada día será más hermosa, más constructiva y tendrá un futuro como el que todos soñamos. Amamos la cultura norteamericana como en los Estados Unidos se ama la cultura cubana. No se puede hablar tampoco de la cultura cubana sin tomar en cuenta la cultura norteamericana, sobre todo en la música, la literatura y las artes, y viceversa, porque afortunadamente nuestro país, que tiene una gran riqueza cultural, ha sido una permanente influencia en la cultura popular de los Estados Unidos. Son vasos comunicantes que se fortalecen con todas las expresiones de nuestra música y de nuestra poesía. Les envío un abrazo a todos y les agradezco que sigan combatiendo ese horrendo bloqueo que estrangula la economía del pueblo cubano. Ese bloqueo que nada tiene que ver con figuras tan gloriosas para nosotros como Abraham Lincoln y Martin Luther King. José Martí, nuestro apóstol, vivió en Estados Unidos, apreció la cultura norteamericana, pero también condenó a las corporaciones y dijo que había vivido en ese monstruo y conocía sus entrañas, refiriéndose justamente a ese mundo imperial que iba surgiendo cada día con más fuerza. Les deseo a todos muchos éxitos en esta conferencia y espero que sepan que aquí estamos nosotros también apoyándolos a ustedes y deseándoles un futuro mejor porque se lo merecen. I hope we will overcome. Thank you. Thank you.
The song I'm going to sing for you is a song I composed in 1995. It is a poem from Vicente Cepeda, a Chilean author, which I set to music as a tribute for the centenary of the death of José Martí. I have no doubt at all that if Martí would still be alive today, he would have been against the US blockade of Cuba. So, just for you, alas de libertad, para ustedes, the wings of liberty.
We are struggling to make clean air and clean water a reality, even as landfills overflow and food deserts grow. After the collapse of its major ally, Cuba used her creative juices to pioneer urban farming and develop chemical-free agriculture. Their bioconservation efforts have served as a model for other nations. Surely there are lessons we can learn from Cuba, named the most sustainable country in the world in 2015. But our countries cannot have rich intellectual exchanges because of the blockade. So we lose. Thank you.
Oh. This is Jack Hirschman from San Francisco. I'm going to read a poem about a friend of all of us, Fidel Castro. The president of the other America has fallen ill, and it's his birthday. We wish him a happy birthday and a speedy recovery. By the other America, we don't simply mean his brothers and sisters in Venezuela, Bolivia, Chile, Peru, Brazil, Haiti, and the like. We mean also the 37 million people living destitute and in misery in these disunited states, of whom millions of kids go to bed hungry every night, while a murder machine waves the false flag of security and makes war on the poor of the world. What's more insecure than the empty belly of a child? The president of the other America knows that there's a poverty that is the wealth of the world. Viva the poverty of Cuba that makes even the comrade on the cross applaud. Viva the dignity of Cuba, whose island arms stretch all the way to the equality of love that is Africa. There is a man who has understood that life is worth nothing if it is not free, and freedom nothing if it is not consciousness of necessity, principled, palpable, and priceless. That is Fidel. That is Fidelidad. Be well, Comandante. Feliz cumpleaños. Now I would like to read a poem by a great El Salvadorian poet, Roque Dalton. I believe he wrote this poem in Cuba. I regard this as one of the great poems of this past two generations. First in Spanish, Acta. En nombre de quienes lavar ropa ajena y expulsando la blancura la mugre ajena. En nombre de quienes cuidan hijos ajenos y venden su fuerza de trabajo en forma de amor maternal y humillaciones. En nombre de quienes habitan en vivienda ajena y aún los mastican con sentimiento de ladrón. En nombre de quienes viven en un país ajeno, las casas y las fábricas y los comercios y las calles y las ciudades y los pueblos y los ríos y los lagos y los volcanes y los montes son siempre de otros. Y por eso está allí la policía y la guardia cuidándolos contra nosotros. En nombre de quienes lo único que tienen es hambre, explotación, enfermedades, sed de justicia de agua, persecuciones, condenas, soledad, abandono, opresión, muerte. Yo acuso a la propiedad privada de privarnos de todo. Act in the name of those washing others' clothes and cleaning others' filth from the whiteness, in the name of those caring for their children and selling their labor power in the form of maternal love and humiliations, in the name of those living in another's house, which isn't even a kind belly but a tomb or a jail, in the name of those eating others' crumbs and chewing them still with the feeling of a thief, in the name of those living on others' land The houses and factories and shops, streets, cities and towns, rivers, lakes, volcanoes and mountains always belong to others, and that's why the cops and the guards are there, guarding them against us. In the name of those who have nothing but hunger, exploitation, disease, a thirst for justice and water, persecutions and condemnations, loneliness, abandonment, oppression, and death. I accuse private property of depriving us of everything.
Climate collapse has led to stronger natural disasters here in the U.S., where one out of three Americans lives less than 2 hours from a coastline. Fire, floods, hurricanes. This year has seen a record-setting 25 named storms, causing hundreds of deaths and $33 billion worth of property damage. Thousands have been left homeless. Meanwhile, the tiny nation of Cuba has become a model for disaster preparedness that integrates the community, boosts resilience, and saves lives. But American officials can't learn from Cuba's model of a culture of safety because of the blockade. So again, we lose.
Voy a leer dos poemas del cuaderno Madrigal para un príncipe negro que acaba de aparecer de forma virtual en el sitio web de la Casa de las Américas. Este poema tiene una cita de Federico García Lorca que dice: las pupilas no tienen horizontes. George Floyd defiende su horizonte. Ángel o diablo, George Floyd tenía derecho a contemplar los astros buscando un horizonte prestado o alquilado o como quieran. Hablan sobre los ángeles las sagradas escrituras cuando mientan al diablo con desvelo. Ángel o diablo, George Floyd tenía derecho a tener una vida, a contemplar los astros mientras buscaba un horizonte suyo y eterno, un horizonte. Un príncipe negro para George Floyd. Aunque su sueño era lanzarte al Mississippi, aquel caníbal de uniforme opaco ha quemado en silencio su rodilla sobre tu cuello inerte. El humo de tu carne va subiendo hasta el cielo mojado, saltando entre las flores, el aire de tus bronquios persigue su fantasma hasta morder el colmillo sangriento del caníbal. Y tú alientas indómito sobre el asfalto húmedo bajo la sombra quieta de un manzano en Minneapolis, donde colocaremos para ti este brillante, este limpio príncipe negro nuestro a tu memoria.
What a beautiful demonstration of love and solidarity. At the end of October, Cuban Foreign Minister Bruno Rodriguez announced to the world that 2020 has been the costliest year of the over 60-year blockade against Cuba. Trump's vicious tightening of the economic, commercial, and financial blockade caused over $5 billion in damages against the island's economy. Since the COVID-19 pandemic began, the Trump administration has introduced further punishing measures, including limiting remittances sent from family members in the United States. Most recently, restrictions on Cuban rum and tobacco imports to the United States were increased alongside a redoubling of the U.S. efforts to cut Cuba off from Venezuelan oil imports. Despite these cruel measures taken against Cuba, the possibility of ending the blockade has never been closer. Organizers of the International U.S.-Cuba Normalization Conference invite you to participate in the first post-U.S. election action to end the cruel and unjust U.S. blockade of Cuba with three special online events organized for tomorrow and Sunday. These events will focus on action and expanding international collaboration and movement building to defeat, once and for all, the blockade and secure U.S.-Cuba normalization as demanded by the peoples of the world, including clear majorities in the United States. Speakers at the weekend of events include the Cuban ambassador to the United States, the Cuban ambassador to Canada, as well as doctors, scholars, elected officials, labor and religious figures, representatives of the Cuban American community, and leading solidarity organizers in the United States, Canada, Quebec, and Puerto Rico. To learn more and to register for the weekend of events, click the link in the chat or visit www.us-cubanormalization.org. As we continue our program tonight of culture and solidarity, we are honored to have Pablo Menendez y Mezcla, Moncada, Arturo O'Farrell, Synthesis, L. Jones, Telmarie, El Septeto Santiaguero, and Havana de Primera. Enjoy the second half of our show.
Not so far from here, there's a very lively atmosphere. Everybody's going there this year. There's a reason the season opened last July. Ever since the USA went dry, everybody's going there and I'm going too. I'm on my way to Cuba, that's where I'm going. Cuba, that's where I'll stay. Cuba, where rum is flowing and every dark eyes stella. Lights of fellas, panatella, Cuba. We're always happy, hey Cuba. We're always gay. Why don't you plan a wonderful trip to Havana? Hop on a ship and I'll see you in CBA. Everyone who's got the ticket price should visit Cuba. If you've been longing for a smile that you haven't seen in quite a while, come along and follow me and I'll show you the way. I'm on my way to Cuba, that's where I'm going. Hey, Cuba, that's where I'll stay. Cuba, where rum is flowing and every dark eye's stella. Lights of fellas, Panadera, Cuba.
One out of five American adults suffers from illiteracy or low literacy. And that number increases to 70% for those behind bars. According to our nation's report card, only one out of three students is reading on grade level in the 4th, 8th, and 12th grades. But Cuba has designed an innovative community-based program that has taught reading and writing to over 10 million people in 30 countries and across 20 languages. But we can't access this pioneering program because of the blockade. So we're the ones that lose out.
Un hombre quiso mirarse por dentro y se sentó en el tronco de un árbol. No era filósofo, sabio ni eterno, pero ese día sus ojos brillaron como una estrella se abriéndose el pecho. Aunque por poco se quema las manos, quiso dejar que los rayos del tiempo le devolvieran su imagen de humano. Quiso mirar y encontró un paraíso, quiso mirar y encontró el infierno, quiso mirar lo que siempre nos duele, quiso mirarse por dentro. Yo sé hormiga gigante, transformadora de cosas y nombres. Con mis tenazas peinaré las nubes, pero prometo no aplastar al hombre. Tiene Cupido mala puntería, tiene una flecha y dos corazones. Si se equivoca pierdo la cabeza, solo te salvas el niño paloma. Quiso mirar y encontró un paraíso, quiso mirar y encontró el infierno, quiso mirar lo que siempre nos duele, quiso mirarse por dentro. Yo opino que el amor no es una línea, yo opino que el amor no es un esquema. La soledad puede ser habitable, este es el día en que todo revienta. Si plantas flores, pregunta primero si eres capaz de cuidarlas a diario. De lo contrario, vete jardinero, cambia de oficio, sigue de largo. Quiso mirar y encontró un paraíso, quiso mirar y encontró el infierno. Quiso mirarse por dentro. Un hombre quiso mirarse por dentro y se sentó en el tronco del mundo. No era un capricho o algo misterio, como los sueños de un náufrago mudo. Si se deciden hacer ese viaje, lleven estrellas marinas y agrarias, un sol cuadrado, color escarlata, y ahí estará vuestra aldea planetaria. Quiso mirar y encontró un paraíso, quiso mirar y encontró el infierno, quiso mirar lo que siempre nos duele, quiso mirarse por dentro.
Yeah.
todo reverdecía. Thank you.
Orulan,
Climate collapse has led to stronger natural disasters here in the U.S., where one out of three Americans lives less than 2 hours from a coastline. Fire, floods, hurricanes. This year has seen a record-setting 25 named storms, causing hundreds of deaths and $33 billion worth of property damage. Thousands have been left homeless. Meanwhile, the tiny nation of Cuba has become a model for disaster preparedness that integrates the community, boosts resilience, and saves lives. But American officials can't learn from Cuba's model of a culture of safety because of the blockade. So again, we lose.
Greetings, everybody. My name is Elle Jones, and I'm joining you from Jabuktuk, Halifax, in Nova Scotia, the unceded and unsurrendered territories of the Mi'kmaq people. And I'm going to read a couple of poems for you. The first one is in honor of Moncada Day. I am the weapon fired in the barracks at Moncada. I am the first blow struck for liberty in the resistance. I am the raised fist and the heroism of the martyr. I am not a rifle, shotgun, or pistol. My ammunition is the ideal of equality sown in the minds of the parking lot attendants, delivery boys, chauffeurs, and street vendors. The 25 rebels raised without fathers. The legacy of oppression felt in every ghetto from Rio de Janeiro to Harlem. I am the bullet in the chamber loaded in Santiago in the speeches of Eduardo Ribas. I'm broadcast in the barrios on the People's Free Radio. I am Viva la Cuba Libre in embryo. Spoken in Spanish and Creole and stoked in poverty and broken homes until it was shown in growing whispers among the youth on the streets and in universities. I am the truth. And the grassroots marching in the boots from day laborers to Che Guevara. I am the ancestral memory of the sugarcane fields, the machete passed from the hands of 2 cent warriors in Haiti to the Cuban sugar workers laboring in the heat. I am snatching victory out of the jaws of defeat. I am the speeches written from the prison cell and the spit in the eye of the torturer. I am Fidel's courtroom testimony. When I descend, I strike a blow for solidarity. I am the revolution waged since 1492, begun in the resistance of indigenous Taino and Arawak and sustained in their descendants laboring in tobacco plantations. I am embargo and self-sustaining. I am guerrilla tactics learned on the 26th of July. I am the absolution of history. I am the ongoing battle for independence from the American attacks from 1906 to Guantanamo occupation. My echo has been felt from Palestine to Iraq in every national struggle for liberation. I am the refusal to bow to imperialism. I am the destruction of class division. I am the 300 million of the people's money Batista carried into exile. I raise fists against corruption. I march miles for the people's rights. I am the general strike. I am the shot fired across the color line for the mulattoes and Afro-Cubanos, the shades not light enough to work in hotel cabanas. I am the legacy of slavery, an African birthright whose beat runs through the salsa and mambo. I am the spirit of Baba Shango. I put the heat in the Cold War. I am street festivals and the resistance of the poor. I am the redistribution of land and local ownership. I am nationalization of industry, collective agriculture, and public education. I am the constitution that says the people own the nation. I am the belief that rice and peas served to all people taste sweeter than steaks served to the elite. The shots I fire are completed in Cuban doctors saving earthquake victims and free healthcare extended across the Caribbean. I am brown and black people's freedom. I am the troops sent to Angola to fight South African apartheid. I am asylum offered to Assata Shakur in political exile. The blows I strike have been felt from Bolivia to Venezuela. I am the coca farmers and the baseball players and the peasants fighting oil corporations in the Amazon basin. I am the battle for land repatriation and slave reparations, the Caribbean workers in the free trade zone sewing sweatshop labels. I am the union organizers on Dominican sugar batays, the squatters' rights and transnationalization of indigenous populations, the indigenous confederations fighting from Brazil to Peru. I am the Cuban revolution, and I will survive beyond Castro because I am the shot fired in the name of equality by heroes and martyrs. I am Moncada. I am Havana. I am the ideal that thrives in the minds of the people. I am liberation. Thank you, everybody. I'm going to read one more poem. This poem is called Happy Birthday, Fidel, and it's both a tribute to Fidel and also a reminder in these times of how we have to keep the true revolutionary flame burning and not allow our activities to be co-opted. Dear Fidel, this is a birthday card from the wretched of the earth. So I'm sorry if it's birthed in blood or written in the drops of sweat from the brows of the ones who dream of enough bread and not of cake. This is a bringing into life that never stops. This card is reaping the crops you sowed, and it's getting ahead of itself because it is always imagining a better, and a better tomorrow. You may not be able to make the letters out because this is a tribute from the ones denied education in countries without your literacy programs that allow the neglected to make it out of poverty. So instead of happy birthday, it says hasta la victoria siempre with a postscript. We believe the worker has an equal stake in the society they labor to build. This is a birthday card. Filled from the ache in the belly of the planet's hungry. So they will not wish you steak for birthday dinner, but invite you to humbly share their rice and beans. And the message on the napkin folded into a card says, we will not leave your vision unfulfilled. This card is the hallmark of resistance. Greetings from the ones who get no break working 15 hours a day beside a sewing machine. The teens at border crossings and refugees in container ships seeking escape, who send the message, thank you for jolting the world awake. Thank you for shaking our foundations, and in the rubble finding a place where equality is still a possibility and the ideal will never die. And FYI, we are tired of fake promises of liberation. We want the real thing, born from cane fields and street vendors in the heat of Black August and the drumbeat of emancipation. These are our wishes when we blow the candles out because there's no electricity and we have to say. We have to say and be safe. This is a birthday card from the crater left after the invasion, and it echoes. It echoes with the news not heard on network TV. You can label it propaganda if you like, or you can call it the unheard cries of the majority making less than a dollar and a quarter a day. This is a card the CIA is trying to erase, and it is not sold in Miami, but it is scraped together from tips of hotel workers and your mammy's 7-a-day-a-week job as a domestic and her layoff notice when her knees gave out and made from recycled trash in the dump where children play. Down here among the unclean, where schools don't have a latrine and the politicians come to power and are only figurines, the bombs fall on the hospital stoked by puppet regimes and they tell us revolution is just a whisper because its goals remain unseen. So this is a birthday card from the heart that keeps the flame burning, from those who are not turning away. The sparks that light up police stations and say, take your knees off our neck. And Houston Che Guevara and Black Lives Matter tees chanting death to imperialism and no justice, no peace, while a corporate execs rake in another bailout check and the illusion of choice extends for another election run, but we are not done. And we are sending you a message saying, Fidel, we do not forget your name. So this is a birthday card from the bus drivers who refused to deliver protesters to jail. No, the revolution did not fail. It is in the defiant fists of the rioters being arrested in Zimbabwe, the torch handed from Mandela shouting Viva la Cuba Libre upon his release from his apartheid cell. This is a birthday card heard in the rebels' yell and the sound of the colonizer's statue breaking as it fell. This is a birthday card from all who go without presents because we believe in a better future. A dream sutured into us at the hands of Cuban doctors, from the peasants and ghetto residents and political dissidents convicted on manufactured evidence. This is happy birthday sung by a chorus of minimum wage workers while they cover their mouths because their corporate boss denies them PPE. No, we are not free. But this card will not be delivered to you by an underpaid worker at Amazon. This card was not brought in Babylon, but created in the dawn of a better world. It unfurls in the flags of regiments marching through Africa and in the smoke of Zapatista camp. It is not in an envelope because it cannot be contained. It only unfolds. It unfolds. It is unfolding. In the eviction notices and summonses to court, but it is unfolding. In the bodies lying on the concrete, it is unfolding beyond death because it cannot die. This is the birthday card deferred for the day we will be celebrating together in freedom when the battle is won. And comrades drop their weapons with tears flowing down their faces, hold hands, and say we have unfolded. We are unfolding. And the message, it still lives on. Solidarity, everybody, and thank you.
Yo, yo, Rad Stars de Rebeldía, siguiendo con el show. Queremos compartir esta historia, una historia de una rebelión en Chile. Nosotros somos los hijos de ese exilio, de la rebeldía de Allende, de Miguel Enrique, donde hubo el primer 11 de septiembre de 1973, donde hubo una dictadura financiada, un golpe financiado por la CIA, financiado con torturadores de la Escuela de las Américas, donde hubieron desaparecido campos, concentración. Y nosotros seguimos con esa memoria rebelde y seguimos siempre en solidaridad con nuestra gente de Cuba, que siempre han sido hermanos de lucha con la gente en Chile. Un saludo al pueblo mapuche, una victoria grande, pero este tema se llama No los dejaré, a nuestros padres que siempre lucharon, y nosotros, la segunda generación, esas semillas de rebeldía, como se dice, trataron de quemar el jardín, pero las semillas crecieron y existen, y seguimos haciendo hip hop, yo, peace.
Yeah. Come on. Yo. Es el 11 de septiembre, voy al choque con los pacos. Yo cargo una escopeta que fue hecha por los cabros. Un fuego bien casero, pero en eso mata gato. La calle tan sola, solo yo y un guanaco. El zapato, el zorrillo, el hip combativo. Lo rico va a su lado porque el pueblo está conmigo. Sácate un limón pa' pelear el lagrimógeno. Sácate un sillón pa' quemarlo en la calle. Una fogata que esté grande con el humo en el cielo. Por lo menos una noche resistimos como pueblo. La noche está cura, empezó el apagón. La dictadura sigue viva, solo se escondió. Y solo le pido a Dios, que recuerde a los niños. Y al final es el futuro que repite la historia. Recupere la memoria, ahora es la hora. Al final de esta vida todo el dolor se termina. Y por eso lucho, lucho contra el sistema. Y nunca pararé luchando. A mi padre se lo digo, se lo juro. Esta vida no fue fácil, sí fue duro. A tu lado estaré para siempre. Hey, no los dejaré a los cabros de la pobla, a la madre que está sola, al viejo cartonero que perdió todo el dinero. Cuando llueve es difícil, los cuicos están secos, las casas de cartón nunca fueron de ellos. Los milicos nunca echaron donde estaban los momios, apoyaban lo que pasaba con el gobierno. Obvio, el mundo de los pobres no es pura miseria, aunque no es material, existe otra riqueza, el calor humano. Se siente entre hermanos cuando el tiempo está difícil, se comparte con un trago. El ejemplo de prestarle la azúcar al vecino. Si hay pan duro, el pan duro compartimos. Solo respiro, las tomas se resisten. Y esto a mí me muestra que la rebeldía existe. Somos los niños del exilio, semilla de rebelión. La guerra que empezaron no se terminó. Hey, no se terminó, terminó. No sé, y al final de esta vida todo el dolor se termina, y por eso lucho, lucho contra el sistema, y nunca pararé luchando. A mi padre se lo digo, se lo juro, esta vida no fue fácil, sí fue duro. A tu lado estaré para siempre. Hey, no los dejaré, no los dejaré, no los dejaré, yeah. Y nunca los dejamos, y nunca los dejamos. Yeah, siempre luchamos, yeah, siempre luchamos, y'all. You know what it is, y'all. Desde el Bronx a Cuba, let's go. Y'all, Bad Stars de Rebeldía, representando. Salud a mi gente de Cuba, y'all. Cambio en el clima, cambia tu rima, cambia todo, cambia, pregúntale a mi ex mina. Hijo del Mirzo, venceremos Samón, la verena, Venezuela, spin veneno, Rodrigo Starr, send money to my Venmo, Venbro, a la ciudad de viento, capitalismo violento como mi verso, agarra un martillo y muele un beso, agarra un militar, ese de los vendíos, martíale un dedo para cada uno de los míos, cada vez que da un grito, es cada
vez que yo me río me da paja lidiar con tantos pajarones. Olor a gasolina, cause I burn microfones. Son fome pero bien famoso. Tanto gang gang que quedé gangoso. Hello, después le hago un oso. Puta que me la gozo, comparte tu torta. I need a piece, until then I'm rapping all over your beats. Rap right now looking like something to eat. Something that later I pick out of my teeth. Smoke loud, exhale the humo. Still hungry, no desayuno. Rebel leader, in 89 like Hugo. El Venega, Verdugo, and you know I got the jugo. Soy fumón, hasta quemo el micrófono. Yo soy un artista, vos pintáis mono. Se forran con dólares pa' comprar gorro. Me pongo zapatillas, el color de oro. Pongo oro sólido y bailo merengue con una morenita that I met on mi gente. When I was 20, but now I got canas. And she got little chuchu, she your favorite baby mama. I'm your favorite cubre cama. I was walking in La Habana in some stolen Nike chalas. I'm old school like your mom getting mad and throwing chanclas. My headphone play antibalas. A chileno it goes like bam bam and salas. The only Christopher we acknowledge is Wallace. Oh, let's go. Rod Stars, Rebel Diaz. Vamos. ¿Qué pasa, mi gente de Cuba? Mandándole un saludo directamente del Bronx. You know what it is, y'all.
Se conecta con tú sabes.
We have lost nearly 250,000 people to COVID-19, while Cuba has lost only 129 of its citizens. This is thanks in part to Cuba's community-based approach to healthcare. In fact, Cuba has sent doctors to over 40 nations to help their healthcare workers fight the virus. Cuba is also home to the largest medical school in the world, with 20,000 students from 110 countries. But our doctors, nurses, and medical schools can't go learn best practices that would make them more effective in the fight against this global pandemic. So, we lose.
Thank you. apaga.
Suelta perro mayora, cuida con el cimarrón, con su gata güey. A ver si late igual que el mío. Déjame déjame entrar en tus venas. A ver si tu sangre es roja. Muéstrame tu piel desnuda. A ver si reacciona el frío. Y si eres diferente, quizás te pueda entender. Y si eres diferente, quizás te pueda entender. A la memoria de Laureano Orell. Devuélveme la sonrisa, déjame quererte así, transparente y sin maldad. Y entiéndeme cuando llore, y por los años que he vivido, intentando convencerte desde que soy igual que tú. Y si mi color te enoja y no me dejas quererte, al menos no me des muerte con tu rodilla en mi cuello. Deja al menos la esperanza de que exista un mundo sano y reconoce lo bello que se siente ser humano. Colombia.
Llenaste mi vida de muerte. Ya rompiste mi alma en pedazos. Ahora llena de flores tus brazos. Y al menos déjame quererte.
Vamos, mírame a los ojos y mira bien el sufrimiento y el dolor. Somos una sola raza, un diferente color. Escucha bien. A hueso, a hueso. Mañana son mañana.
Lo que no te mata, ya se va.
pedazo como eso. Que se corta robando pan. Batalla gamonero. Yo soy José Meri Benito Leo. José Meri Benito. José Meri Benito Leo. José Meri Benito. Y acá acaba su cuele.
Buenas tardes. Bueno, súper contento de estar aquí. Una vez más, ahora de primera para ustedes. Nada, que se mantenga este intercambio cultural, que podamos seguir intercambiando el arte, la música, la paz, la energía positiva, que sobre todo es lo que nos hace falta en este mundo hoy. Vamos arriba, Yemo. Seguimos, bueno, tema que nos identifica. Bueno, no lo voy a presentar. Ahí va. Tíralo, Yemo. Calienta la tierra, y ahí donde el corazón late más sincero. Vengo de donde el sol pasa las horas, enamorando a la rumba, cantándole aquel bolero. Y traigo mi religión y mi esperanza, mezclada con mi tambor y mi melodía. Tan solo quiero que sepas lo que se siente cuando se llene tu alma de toda mi cubanía. Cubano soy de pura cepa y mis raíces las defiendo con la vida. Cubano soy y donde quiera que me encuentre el sol calienta la tierra, la tierra donde nací, donde viviré. Por eso te canto ahora mi canción, para que sepas el porqué.
Muchas gracias. Ahí nomás. Ahora primera para ustedes.
What an amazing group of performers coming together for friendship, love, and solidarity. We want to thank everyone that helped make this event possible, especially the artists who have contributed their talents towards this international effort to expand the ongoing campaign to end the U.S. blockade on Cuba. Between April 2019 and March 2020, the criminal U.S. blockade caused $160 million in damages to Cuba's healthcare system alone. Despite these ongoing challenges, Cuba continues to lead the way in the struggle against the COVID-19 pandemic. Currently, there are 3,700 Cuban medical workers serving in 39 countries and territories with the Henry Reeve International Medical Brigades. At the same time, Cubans' medicines and treatments are being used around the world, and Cuba has also been very successful at fighting COVID-19 within its own borders. Cuba's leading role in the fight against the pandemic calls on all of us to redouble our efforts to end the nearly 60-year-old criminal U.S. blockade, and we want to encourage everyone to join us in the continuing actions, especially our weekend of solidarity to end the U.S. blockade on Cuba this Saturday and Sunday, November 14th and 15th. Tonight's concert would not have been possible without the support of Hot House Global and the hard work of my co-organizers in the International U.S.-Cuba Normalization Conference Committee. Video editing and live streaming was by Vedran Ray Films, and the concert was co-produced by Raul Cuza from Havana, Cuba. We also send a special thanks to the Instituto Cubano de la Música and La Rueda Producciones. Thank you to Kimberly Waller, Catherine Murphy, and Azza Rojbi for the slides about the impact of the blockade on Cuba on the people in the United States. We hope to see all of you at the next 2 days of events calling for an end to the U.S. blockade on Cuba. For more information and to register, click the link in the chat or visit www.us-cubanormalization.org. Long live friendship and solidarity. Viva Cuba. Viva la amistad y la solidaridad. See you this weekend.
Traigo el son ritmo sabroso de Cuba.